Chapter 12, The Gift of Discernment Working in the Prophet. The discerning prophet must exercise keen judgment and develop sensitivity in dealing with the human condition. In addition, when dealing with God's people, the prophet must continue to reverence God. As the prophet receives revelation from God, he must recognize that he is literally standing in the very presence of God and in the place of God. The prophet is standing before the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the sovereign, righteous, and holy God. The prophet's hands must be clean and his heart pure. He must be free from the soulful lusts and vanity of the world. His mouth must never speak deceitfully. The instructions in this paragraph are foundational to proper discernment. Through the anointing of God, the discerning servant of the Lord must always say only what God says. He must become blind to everyone and everything except God. The word of God speaks on this wise concerning the prophet of the Lord, "Who is blind but my servant?" Isaiah 42:19. If his soul is entangled with the affairs of this life, the prophet will not be able to operate in the pureness of his calling. The young prophet will learn that he is able to see things long before others and, as we have discussed earlier, even before his leaders. Often because of immaturity, the young prophet is unable to fully articulate and communicate what is seen in the Spirit. This is another slippery slope, whereby the young prophet can end up accusing everyone of being against him. Satan will trick him in departing from the care and covering of his apostolic headship. Once again, there is a need for mentoring by a seasoned prophet who is able to teach the young prophet how to properly discern God's word and his instructions. One instance of this type of mentoring relationship is between Moses and Joshua, the son of Nun. As Moses came down from the mountain, and as he and Joshua entered the camp, Joshua's first impression was that the sound he heard was the sound of war. Through his veteran experience as a prophet and because of his seasoned sense of discernment, Moses taught Joshua how to properly discern the sound. This pattern of mentoring takes place in several instances in Scripture. For instance, when Elisha and the young sons of the prophets were gathering food to put into the pot, one of the young prophets gathered a wild vine. The vine was poisonous and would have killed them all. When they saw death in the pot, the sons screamed out to Elisha. Elisha was able to bring healing to the food. The healing in the pot allowed them to receive a wholesome and healthy meal. There is a difference between discernment and divination. Discernment means, one, to sense or come to know something that is hidden or obscure, and two, to make a distinction between good and evil. Divination is the art or practice that seeks to foretell future events or disclose hidden knowledge by the use of an agar, soothsayer, or diviner. There are churches that provide secret havens for those directly under the influence of the spirit of divination. Without proper discernment, these activities go undetected. The line of demarcation between the prophet of God and the false prophet is motive. Discover the motive and you will get to the bottom line. The gift of divination is as simple as a card trick or fortune telling, where a fortune teller simply reads a person. If you live long enough, you will be able to measure up a person pretty well simply by looking at them, by taking note of the way they dress, by the way they talk, their accent and dialect, etc. This is what false prophets do in the church while masquerading as prophets of God. Divination is witchcraft. Sadly, most people are unaware of the difference. Beware! Money and fortune-telling often go together. The church cannot operate effectively without money, and not every offering received is evil. However, when money becomes the main focus of the church, it should be a red flag. Fasting, consecration, and reverence to God are all vital in receiving proper discernment. In order to share the divine oracles of God with humanity, the prophet must be honest and sincere about his calling to the office of the prophet. Questions. Number 1. Why is sensitivity and prophetic discernment vital to the one who receives a prophecy? Number 2. What character traits can degrade proper discernment by the prophet? Number 3. Has there been a time in your ministry when your indulgence in carnal or worldly things hindered your discernment of the will of God? Number 4. How do the principles of Ephesians 4:13-16 apply to the life of the prophet?